We invoke the grace of our Gurus and the Almighty to enhance our knowledge and get further clarity that should lead us to the furthest aim of what true education is. The topic for today is liberal education. The word education or the word educate is derived from the Latin root, which means to draw out. So the essential purpose of education is to draw out from within ourselves. Opposed to this is what is being pushed in from outside. So what is liberal education and what is servile education? These two terms, liberal education and servile education, are terms specifically coined by a great English thinker in the 19th century by the name Newman. He is a cardinal. Cardinal Newman uses these two terms, liberal education and servile education. Servile education is an education undertaken with a utility motive. If we undertake any education with the aim of what I can get out of this education, there is a utility tag attached to that education. That education is called as servile education. Servile education is something which devalues the education. A person undergoes a course in engineering or medicine or any other subject for that matter with the aim of how can I use this knowledge, or will it get me a job or something like that? If that is the motive, then that education is devalued. He terms that as servile education. Now, what could be the cause of servile education? Over the years, not only in India, all over the world, education has turned servile. What is the purpose of this education? Where will it fetch me finally? This is the idea with which people approach education. One of the ideas could be that maybe a post-industrial revolution or something where there is a lot of idea of how people's education can be utilized in various structures of the organization, servile education gained more and more weightage. Say for example, if a person studies commerce, this BCom as a course is a very very recent addition to the education. If a person studies commerce, he will fit into this portion of the office, maybe in the portion of accounts or whatever department where it will be used. If a person studies engineering, he will fit into this portion of the factory or the office where his education can be used. If a person studies some other law or something, his ideas can be used in the legal department of the organization. So like that, each and every education was designed in such a way that it will fit into a particular facet of an organization, and it is with this idea that the education became important. It was being important based on this idea only. So the whole education system became servile. So in other words, the idea of undertaking or wanting to get educated for the sake of value of the knowledge, that was not there. There was no undertaking of the education or wanting to get educated for the sake of the beauty of knowledge, for the sake of learning. So the true learning where it is involved, it is called as liberal education. Liberal education is where you want to get educated for the sake of getting educated, for the sake of knowledge, for the sake of quest for knowledge. Will there not be any utility? There will be utility. Obviously you are going to definitely use that knowledge and it is going to come handy. But that is not the purpose or motive with which you approach the education. So liberal education and servile education, this is the way in which Cardinal Newman used. And what is the effect of servile education? It has been long enough for us to even see various results. Certain of these results are correlated on a direct cause and effect basis. Certain things, they are augmented by this servile education. In other words, servile education has produced certain effects. Servile education has added to certain undesired effects for which it may not be the direct cause. First and foremost thing, servile education has killed the joy of learning. For most students in school level and in college level, not only for students, even for teachers, there is no real joy in going to school. When someday if there is a holiday declared, there is more celebration, right? Because of rain or something, if they say today is a holiday, students tend to be overjoyed because of the holiday. Nobody looks forward to going to school. And this is the same principle that comes little later in his life, that he is not able to enjoy his office work also. It starts from the school, it goes into the college. And what is the motivation for many people to go to college is that you will meet friends. That is one motivation. That there are other areas that college can provide a relief or a vent apart from education, which may motivate you to go to college. But just for the joy of learning the knowledge, nobody seems to go to the college or any university or school. By and large, I am saying, schools have become a prison, not only for students but for teachers also. The teachers are also very much stressed and strained. They have to finish the portions and syllabus within certain time, and this is what they are also very much running against time all the time. So we see that they are also quite stressed and they have no real joy. Though there is a passion for teaching, the overburden of the work and the approach of education actually puts a lot of stress and strain on the teachers also. Now, they are also product of the same system of education that they have gone through, and that is being now passed on to the next generation as students. So first of all, when you undertake education for the sake of utility motive, the focus is not on education but what I will get out of education. The joy content in learning that particular subject or any general subject also goes away. So it kills the joy of learning. It sets in monotony. Oh, I have to finish the exam, or there's a boredom that sets in. This is what is the first defect of a servile education. Next, the servile education, since it is in the mode of getting you prepared for the utility purpose, which is a job or something like that, it sets in a rat race amongst the students. So there is a herd instinct for marks, there is a herd instinct for, let us say, jobs, or there is a studying abroad, whatever be the reason, a person is pushed into that mode. He is completely going into the mode of a rat race before he realizes he is into a competition. Healthy competition is necessary, but he does not know what it is meant for. So suppose you ask a student, what is he working for? He will say he has to pass the final examination. There's a marks involved in it. And based on the marks, there will be seat that is available in the college or university. And based on which, there is a placement and other things that comes to the campus, and based on which he has to get the job. So before he could think in terms of what he is really getting educated about, he is pushed into a rat race. So he has no other focus, he has no time to think in terms of what really that subject is saying or what really is the effect of such knowledge, but he is going into what is known as this rat race. This is the second effect. Third is, as a side effect of this, what comes is nervousness, what comes is fear. So those various things which are a student life, he is supposed to enjoy during student life, he is not doing. When there is an examination, there is a fear, there is nervousness. Not only that, later when he goes into the group discussion and interviews also, there is a lot of nervousness, etc. This is because the mind is preoccupied with the result of that education. So since he is not able to concentrate on what he has to study and what is the purpose of education, he is not able to get over the fears and nervousness about this. So These are all unwanted things. Now, I think every last Sunday, our Prime Minister gives Man Ki Baat, right? Which is a good thing that he is able to directly communicate to the citizens of the country. In one of the Man Ki Baat, he even brought in, I think, Vishwanathan Anand and Sachin Tendulkar to give advice to the students with reference to how to keep yourself calm during exams. It is a good gesture, and he is trying all that he can to calm the students' mind before exams. But what from that level can be thought out and done is, why not make the education system simple enough, joyful enough, that student need not go through that stress and strain. Of course, each and everything is individual specific as to one how approaches it. But the system of education itself is such that in this country, that there is a lot of pressure, there is a lot of stress and strain, and therefore students have to be now counseled before examination. To that extent we have come, that he has to overcome fear, that he has to overcome lack of self-confidence, etc. So these are not the things that school is going to focus about. The school is also focused about how they are going to get 100% results. That stress and tension is for the management and the teachers there. So in this rat race, the student also loses his mind and he gets into fear, nervousness, etc. And this lack of concentration next is compounded by other issues like how he deals with relationship, etc. Particularly in adolescent age, when there is a lot of natural inclination towards, we are not against any of these things, but he really doesn't know how to handle these relationships. And when he gets too far ahead of it without control, that adds to the concentration that he is not able to already have in studies. So these are further compounded because he needs a vent and he has a relief only in that area. So therefore, when he goes there, his studies, which is the main purpose of going to school, is affected. In the last many decades, you think of, there have been very many movies in Bollywood and other languages in India. Any regional language you take, or Hindi or any other language, there have been many, many stories revolving around college and schools. Just try to think of any movie that focused on education in any of these movies. Just one. There have been thousands and thousands of movies. So what has been drawn or put into the student's mind is that school and college time is meant for enjoyment, and love and other things are the most important thing. We are not saying about their utility now. That is a different subject altogether. But the most important thing in a student's life, which is studies, which is to prepare him for the life after that. Obviously, if a movie is taken on that storyline, who will watch? If there is a song sequence, if there is a dance, if there is a fight, if there is rowdyism, that will add spice and masala to the movie. That is watchable. But this is not watchable. Even if you take the movie like recently there was an American movie, right? Three Idiots, where they are talking a little about how one should approach the subject, etc. There should be other aspects of the movie also to make it more watchable or enjoyable. So the point is, so much has been drilled into our mind that the school life and college life is just meant for enjoyment, studies is secondary, this sort of a attitude is settled. And all this deviation is there because the prime focus of love for education is not inculcated. Now it can be really developed. That's what we are, that will be the focus of this talk. And lastly, that addiction that a student goes through, now people are complaining about, this is not exhaustive, I've just gathered a few points, that they become a slave to technology. You ask any teacher, any parent, they are complaining about how the student is addicted to now tablets and mobile phones. Now, this is not something that the present generation student is alone is addicted. You go to your generation, the previous generation, the father and mother would have complained about addiction to Star Television and other 24 hours what runs as a satellite channels. Before that, it could be just television. Before that, In 70s, they could have said, oh, I don't know what that he is doing, always keeping a transistor in the ear and listening to commentary, they will say. So this has been a perennial issue in some form or the other that is there. But the addiction, which is technology, is something that has to be appreciated and used. And you have to go along with the technology for that. There's no point lagging behind when the world is moving ahead in technology. It is said now, I saw in a YouTube video, they were saying, out of the videos that are available on YouTube and other social media, everything put together, 70% or 80% or more is pornography. It's a statistic. No, we are not really talking here about morality, ethics, what one should see or one should not see. But just imagine, a platform is given for us now to communicate to the whole world. Technology can be used that way. You can use videos, you can use YouTube, you can use social media like Facebook or Twitter or whatever it is. You can use it to really communicate to the whole world. And what are we really using it? And how does the mind get fully addicted to it? It's a real shame. And if this addiction happens at the student's level, it becomes rather difficult for him to get out of it later. Of course, that's by putting in effort you can get out of it. But the most important formative years of the students gets lost. Now, servile education, I'm not saying it is directly responsible for this, but if the liberal education and the love for liberal education is not inculcated in the student, chances are that we will get into all these problems. This is what servile education is all about, and we need not talk further on servile education, because servile education has been the system of the not only this country, all over the world. Each and every education is, there was a in the book that you will be getting also, those who don't have, taken, take the Fall of Human Intellect as You Go Out. Swamiji has written in that about this liberal and servile education. The education minister of England, when I think a few years back, who was the prime minister under John Major. In his cabinet, there was an education minister who was trying to. Can somebody say? There's no voice coming here. Okay. He was saying that the education minister was saying that there are certain courses that the universities must consider whether they should continue or not. Because he is saying there is no purpose or utility for such education. Cardinal movement, luckily when we talk about Vedanta or Bhagavad Gita, there is a resistance in this country because of secularism. Okay. But what is interesting is the thinkers all over the world have said this. Cardinal Newman is an English person who deplores the state of English universities in 19th century. In 19th century, that's when he coined this. He is deploring the state where at that time Oxford, Cambridge, these are all at the peak of their glory. Such universities are not up to their mark is what Cardinal Newman laments. From the same country, 2 centuries later or 1.5 centuries later, the education minister is saying that such and such courses need not be there in the universities anymore because they don't have any use. Suppose if somebody says, why is there a Sanskrit department in this college? What is the use of Sanskrit? This, if at least a layperson says, we can understand. But if an education minister is saying, that is why in all the lectures, Swamiji very clearly says, education is in the hands of uneducated. So there is no scope. Actually, there is no scope. The education, who decides the course, who is actually controlling how the education has to be implemented, etc. It is actually in the hands of really uneducated people. So education is not really mere degrees. It is, if that is the case of education, there are various purposes to education that we can say. Few decades back, maybe not now, I don't know, there was this problem of dowry in India was of a very great concern. Dowry is what the bride's family should pay to the bridegroom's family. So they were saying all this they are doing because they are not properly educated. If education is there, all this problem, social evils and ills should go. So the education was promoted and people became graduates. But in places like Bihar, Andhra, Orissa and various places when they took statistics, the rate of dowry actually went up after education. So if a person, the bridegroom is of IAS, his rate of dowry is different. If he is of MSc or MCOM, his rate is different. If he is a graduate, his rate is different. So somebody can say, what is the purpose of education? It is just to get more dowry. Those who flew the aircraft into the Twin Towers in 2001 in America, highly educated people, isn't it? They were highly educated. So what has got that education to do with the act that they did? So the education system, what is being taught to us in the schools and colleges, need not necessarily make us truly educated people. So the question arises as to what is liberal education, for which we need to analyze what famously Swamiji calls in every lecture as intellect versus intelligence.
Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.